was working for the Buffalo Courier Express, which was at that time a daily newspaper in Buffalo, and Buffalo newspapers, Niagara Falls newspapers, and papers and magazines all over the world had pictures of Niagara Falls with no water. The falls was dewatered, they called it, many years ago, and all of the water that normally goes over the American rapids and the American falls was shunted over to the Canadian side, and it all went over the Horseshoe Falls on the Canadian side, leaving the American side almost dry, just a trickle of water here and there. And people came from all over the world to see Niagara Falls dry. Normally there's no other way to get out there. You couldn't take a boat or a canoe or a kayak or anything like that because it's a really treacherous rapids. It's really very, very rocky river bottom, and that's how people get swept over the falls. They inadvertently try to step out into the river and they get swept away. But we weren't swept away. We just had the emotion and the feeling of seeing the falls run dry. And how many people would be able to say, I saw the falls run dry twice in my life?